Our hymn is number 341.
God, come to my assistance.
Lord, make haste to help me. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, to God who is, who was, and who is to come, now and forever. Amen. Alleluia. Virgin, heaven's portal fairest, taking that sweet Ave, which by Gabriel spoken, Eve's own name reversing, be of peace the token. Break the sinner's fetters, light to blind restoring, all our ills dispelling, every grace imploring. Show thyself a mother in thy supplication. He will hear who chose thee at his incarnation. Virgin all excelling, passing meek and lowly, win for sinners pardon, make us chaste and holy. As we journey onward, aid our weak endeavor, till we gaze on Jesus and rejoice forever. Father, Son, and Spirit, confessing, give we equal glory, equal praise and blessing.
Rejoice, daughter of Zion. Behold, your God is coming to dwell in you. I rejoiced when I heard them say, let us go to God's house.
And now our feet are standing within your gates, O Jerusalem.
Jerusalem is built as a city, strongly compact.
It is there that the tribes go up, the tribes of the Lord.
For Israel's law it is, there to praise the Lord's name.
There were set the thrones of judgment of the house of David.
For the peace of Jerusalem pray, peace be to your homes.
May peace reign.
I say peace upon you.
For love of the house of the Lord, I will ask for your good. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, to God who is, who was, and who is to come, now and forever. Amen. Rejoice, daughter of Zion. Behold, your God is coming to dwell in you.
Blessed are you, and blessed is the fruit of your womb. If the Lord does not build a house, in vain do its builders labor.
If the Lord does not watch over the city, in vain does the watchman keep vigil.
In vain is your earlier rising, you're going later to rest.
You toil for the bread you eat, when he pours gifts on his beloved while they slumber.
Truly, sons are a gift from the Lord, a blessing, the fruit of the womb.
Indeed, the sons of youth are like arrows in the hand of the warrior.
Oh, the happiness of the man who has filled his quiver with these arrows.
He will have no cause for shame when he disputes with his foes in the gateways. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit. To God who is, who was, and who is to come, now and forever. Amen. Blessed are you, and blessed is the fruit of your womb.
Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb. O Lord, you once favored your land and revived the fortunes of Jacob.
You forgave the guilt of your people and covered all their sins.
You averted all your rage. You calmed the heat of your anger.
Revive us now, God, our helper. Put an end to your grievance against us.
Will you be angry with us forever? Will your anger never cease?
Will you not restore again our life, that your people may rejoice in you?
Let us see, O Lord, your mercy, and give us your saving help.
I will hear what the Lord God has to say, a voice that speaks of peace.
Peace for his people and his friends, and those who turn to him in their hearts.
His help is near for those who fear him, and his glory will dwell in our land.
Mercy and faithfulness have met. Justice and peace have embraced.
Faithfulness shall spring from the earth, and justice look down from heaven.
The Lord will make us prosper, and our earth shall yield its fruit.
Justice shall march before him, and peace shall follow his steps. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, to God who is, who was, and is to come, now and forever. Amen. Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb.
Blessed are you.
Blessed be our Father, who has blessed us in Christ. Alleluia.
Praised be the God and Father of our Lord Jesus Christ,
who has bestowed on us in Christ every spiritual blessing in the heavens.
God chose us in him before the world began, to be holy and blameless in his sight.
He predestined us to be his adopted sons through Jesus Christ.
Such was his will and pleasure, that all might praise the glorious favor he has bestowed on us in his beloved.
In him and through his blood we have been redeemed, and our sins forgiven. So immeasurably generous is God's favor to us.
God has given us the wisdom to understand fully the mystery, the plan he was pleased to decree in Christ.
A plan to be carried out in Christ in the fullness of time, to bring all things into one in him, in the heavens and on earth. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, to God who is, who was, and who is to come, now and forever. Amen. Blessed be our Father, who has blessed us. Alleluia.
From the letter to Galatians. When the designated time had come, God sent forth his Son, born of a woman, born under the law, to deliver from the law those who were subjected to it, so that we might receive our status as adopted sons.
Mode 3. Nigra sum sed formosa, filiae Jerusalem, ide odilexit medex, et introduxit cubiculum sum. My soul proclaims the greatness of the Lord. spirit rejoices in God my Savior.
For he has looked with favor on his lowly servant. From this day all generations will call me blessed.
The Almighty has done great things for me, and holy is his name.
He has mercy on those who fear him. In every generation,
he has shown the strength of his arm. He has scattered the proud in their conceit.
He has cast down the mighty from their thrones, and has lifted up the lowly.
He has filled the hungry with good things, and the rich he has sent away empty.
He has come to the help of his servant Israel, for he has remembered his promise of mercy.
The promise he made to our fathers, to Abraham and his children forever. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, to God who is, who was, and who is to come, now and forever. Amen. Ni grasum sed formosa, fili e Jerusalem, ide odilexit medex, et introduxit me in cubi.
Let us praise God, our Almighty Father, who wished that Mary, his son's mother, be celebrated by each generation. Now in need we ask.
Kyrie eleison.
Kyrie eleison.
O God, work with miracles. You made the Immaculate Virgin Mary share body and soul in your Son's glory in heaven. Direct the hearts of your children to that same glory.
Kyrie eleison.
You made Mary our mother. Through her intercession, grant strength to the weak, comfort to the sorrowing, pardon to sinners. Salvation and peace to all.
Kyrie eleison.
You made Mary full of grace. Grant all men the joyful abundance of your grace.
Kyrie eleison.
Make your church of one mind and one heart in love. And help all those who believe to be one in prayer with Mary, the Mother of Jesus.
Kyrie eleison.
For Father Nathan, for the parishioners of Holy Trinity Church.
For Steve Tomlin, his cancer. For our future oblates, for vocations to our community. To religious life and to the priesthood.
Through the intercession of Our Lady of Guadalupe, we pray you, Lord, for the Americas, for all people living here. We also ask a special help, protection, intercession for the Regina Celi Hermitage Project, for all benefactors, core team, and all volunteers.
For Barbara and
her intentions.
And Katie, and especially for Father Nathan and Father Francis Church.
You crowned Mary, Queen of Heaven. May all the dead rejoice in your kingdom with the saints forever.
Kyrie eleison.
Pater Noster. quies in celis, sanctificetur nomen tuum, adveniat regnum tuum, fiat voluntas tua, sicut in cielo et in terra. Panem nostrum quotidianum da nobis hodie, et dimitte nobis debita nostra, sicut et nos dimittimus debitoribus nostris, et ne nos inducas in tentationem, sed libera nos a malo. Let us pray. O God, Father of mercies, who place your people under the singular protection of your Son's most holy mother, grant that all who invoke the Blessed Virgin of Guadalupe may seek with ever more lively faith the progress of peoples in the ways of justice and of peace. To our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go in the peace of Christ.
Thanks be to God.
May the divine assistance be always with us.
And also with our brothers and sisters.
Martyrology of December the 13th. Memorial of St. Lucy, Virgin and Martyr of Syracuse, Italy. Standing before her judge, she declared that she had no other desire than to please Christ alone. In the 7th century, St. Odilia. Blind from birth, she was miraculously cured on the day of her baptism at the age of 15. Later, she became abbess of the Benedictine monastery of Hohenburg, today Mount of St. Odilia, which had been founded by her father, the Duke of Alsace. Elsewhere, the heavenly birth of numerous other saints whose names are inscribed in the Book of Life.